Back in RU, just trying to get a workout, trying to stay in shape for my next chapter in my life as far as basketball. RU's been everything for me. It's played a major role in my life as far as my development. Taught me a lot of life lessons outside of basketball. A lot of things that I wouldn't trade for the world. A lot of priceless memories. I built a lot of relationships here. Learned a lot of things. I've been here since I was 18, 19, going on 6 years. It's been everything for me. Hey, Scaife, what up though, man?
What's up, man?
What's up?
I see you.
T-Scaife right there. She gonna be something good in the future. Well, she's something good right now, but she has a bright future. This place has taught me a lot. A lot of tough times, injuries, losses, losing seasons. It's taught me a lot, more than basketball. Taught me a lot of life lessons. How to fight through adversity. Basketball has been everything to me. The school has been everything to me. But I'm ready to move on to the next journey in my life. Ready to venture out and see what's out there for me. We're gonna go back to my spot. I got some heat for y'all. I've been cooking up something real good. Something y'all probably don't even know about. Some artwork. Cooking up some fire. But I'm gonna show y'all what I've been working on. I think I got some good dope, some dope pieces that people will really be interested to see. Alright, I started drawing when I was about 11, maybe a little bit before then. Really out of boredom. I remember drawing and like going to church with my mom and just being so bored that I needed something to do. I used to sit in the back of the church with my cousin. We used to just draw, just sketch anything that we would see. But I stopped really at that age, and it wasn't until maybe a few months ago that I picked the pencil back up and I started seeing what I could do with it. I got a few pieces over here. A lot of my drawings, I try to put a piece of me into it. I'm big on culture, urban culture. So a lot of my drawings have to do with black culture. It's kind of promoting black positivity. This is an unfinished one over here. This is a cool piece I got from, got some inspiration from another artist. It's kind of play on the devil and the angels. Kinda, the devil is whispering bad things in your ear, and the angel is whispering good things. You know, it's like, what do you do? A lot of people face that battle on a daily basis. This is one of my favorites, even though I didn't finish yet. It's just promoting the beauty of the woman. Let's skip a couple. This is another I didn't finish yet. I also got this inspiration from another artist I found on social media, and kind of put my own touches on it. Still unfinished, but I like the direction that I'm going in. I'm gonna go meet some friends out in New York City. There's a function going on. A lot of music, just good vibes. So I'm going to go out there, hang with them. I think I'm naturally got into fashion. Just seeing my dad growing up. I remember he used to wear a lot of tailored clothing. All his clothing was tailored, his shirts, his pants, everything. And I just remember how it fit, how it laid on him. It was the perfect fit. And I knew that was something I wanted to do when I grew up. Also, coming from like an athletic background, any athlete that likes looking good, I know they would say they have over a few dozen tennis shoes in their closet. And I think that translated over to me. I had the sneakers, my sneaker game was on point, but I had to figure out what was going to be my style. How could I create full outfits that helped represent who Greg Lewis was? Let's see this. This is one of my favorite jackets. This is a custom jacket made from a good friend back in Baltimore. It's Nicky. He's well known in Baltimore. But it's one of my favorite jackets. I just like the fit of it. It's good fabric too. That blue is popping, bro.